Hi, I'm Fran with Little Windows, and I'm going to show you how to make this beautiful clear Votive candle holder using Little Windows Brilliant Resin and our new clear photo film, which is like an overhead transparency, but it's very high resolution, so your pictures will maintain their quality. The first thing we need to do is get our photos arranged and printed onto the clear photo film. I'm not going to use the photo cropping software because the photos that we want to use are about 2 to 2.5 inches. So instead, I'm going to use Microsoft Word. The first step is to insert your first photograph. So I'm going to insert a picture from a file and select my first picture. And let's do this one to start, using the rulers at the sides to size your pieces appropriately. And I'm going to insert my next photo. Place that here. What you can then do is click on the photo and it will shrink it to the size that you need. Let's make this one a little bit bigger to match, and that's a pretty good crop there. I'm going to actually move this one down and then proceed to the third photo that I need. Insert a picture from my file and select the final one. Now, the way that I'm having my Votive made, I actually need 2 copies of this photograph. There we go. So I've got some extra space here. So what I'm going to do is just duplicate these because I'm positive I'll use these beautiful pictures in another project. This file is ready to print, so you want to save this. Clear Votives. And you're ready to print. Select the printer you'd like to use. Select the quality. I'm going to pick photo paper. The highest quality is what you'd like to select of the options your printer gives you, because you do want to maintain that photo resolution. When you're printing on the clear photo film, be sure that you're printing on the correct side. Each sheet has a sticker that indicates the side that's appropriate for printing. One side is very slick, the other side has a tooth to it, which the ink clings to. Make sure that you let it set and dry for at least 10 to 15 minutes after you print, before you apply resin, just to make sure that the ink has set. We've got our photos, and now we're going to dome them. So if you have 2 doming trays, it makes it very easy because you can make all 4 sides at once. You'll need resin, either 2 small or 1 large mixing cup, a mixing wand, and a timer. You'll need some paper towels and some scissors to cut out your photos, large or small, it doesn't matter. To attach the sides together, we'll be using jump rings. You'll need 8, and these ones are about 8 millimeters. You can use smaller or larger ones, depending on what you like. And then we'll also need a candle to put in the middle when we're done. So the next step is to cut out your photos. I've already cut out these 2. So you're just going to use your scissors, just like cutting any kind of material, and cut this straight along. I like to cut strips first and then go back. Cut them into squares. And then round the corners. Cut out the squares. You will have a couple extra if you print it the way I did. We'll use those for another project. And then we'll just round the corners. My finished piece has resin on both sides, just to have it be a little more stable. We're ready to mix our resins. 30 milliliters of part A and 15 milliliters of part B. So my final mix will be up to the 45 milliliter line. Make sure to wipe the lip of the bottle because you don't want drips to come down. I'll set my timer for 2.5 minutes and stir gently and slowly. Want to scrape the sides and the bottom to make sure that you mix thoroughly. So you can see this is getting clear and lovely. To continue the blending, we're going to let this rest for 5 minutes. So again, set your timer. It's been 5 minutes, so this is well blended. The first thing I'm going to do, because I left this uncovered, is just get any of the debris that might have settled on the top layer and just scrape that out. You may find a bubble or two stuck to the edge, so just get rid of those before you pour. Then you're going to take the resin and pour a puddle about 2 inches in the center of each of your photos. If you're concerned about how much to put on, be conservative. You can always come back and add more. So we'll wait and let this flow to the edges and see if we need more on each one. So I can see these need a little bit more to get them to the edge. You can pour a little bit more into each corner. And that will blend with the part you poured earlier and self-level. If you still have some areas that are not covered, where the resin has not flowed completely to the edge, take your mixing wand and just pull it along to the very edge of your photo. Once these are completely covered, you're going to want to cover them with something like a Tupperware or a shoebox cover, something to keep the dust out while they set up. After these have set up for about 10 minutes, just take a quick peek to make sure that you've got nothing settled on the top and no bubbles in here. I can see here I got a little piece of fuzz. Other than that, they look pretty good. Cover them up and let them set up. It'll take 12 hours until these are ready to flip so that we can put resin on the backside. These have set for about 12 hours and we're ready to pour the backside. So we will flip these over. Make sure that there's enough space between them and that they're supported by the fingers on the board. The other thing I forgot to mention earlier was make sure that you're working on a level surface, because if not, your resin is all going to drift to one edge. We're going to make a batch of the resin. I'll cover this and let it flow. Again, be conservative. You can always come back, spread it around, or put a little bit more. My pieces are set up and ready to turn into a votive. So figure out how you want them to be arranged and then line them up that way. We're going to be drilling holes through each one and then attaching them with jump rings to form the square shape. So what I like to do is take my pieces before I drill and come in about a half inch to the top and the bottom of each one. Line up one to the next and mark where the holes will be, so that they're directly across from one another. These are all ready to drill. So there are two kinds of drills that you can use to create your holes. You can use the mini hand drill, which is very convenient, very easy to use. The first thing you want to do is make sure to get a surface. This is just a piece of cardboard to protect the surface below. You want to find where your hole is going to be. Make sure you're at least 1/8 inch in from the edge, so that you've got some stability. Push down on the drill and then just twist through, and it's going to make that nice clean hole that you need. Once it's through, twist it a few times just to clean out that hole, and then you can twist it back out. The other way that you can drill these holes is by using a power drill. This is the creative drill that we offer at littlewindows.com, and it's a very handy drill, not only for resin pieces, but also if you wanted to make a project with wood or other soft materials. When you're using the Creative Drill, it comes with 5 different sizes of drill bits. I'm going to use the middle size one so that my jump rings can pass through easily. This purl button is what allows you to change those drill bits. You're just going to tighten that up and then it will spin freely. The on-off button is at the bottom here, so let's go ahead and drill. Now let's link these together. Take your jump ring, and we're actually going to open it up so that we can put it through both holes. There we go. This one's going to be like this. I'm just going to put it right through there. And then close that jump ring again. So once again, I'm using my pliers to open up the jump ring, give it a nice wide mouth, and feed that right through my holes, one, and then the other, and then just pinch it closed. If you're using the mini hand drill and you have jump rings that are quite thick, you may have to just widen that hole a little bit. And it'll go right through. On the final two edges, you want to sort of pinch your votive this way so that you can get these closer together. Feed them through both holes. And then that will allow you to pinch it at the top. And the final link, again, I'm going to just feed it through both of the panels, wiggle it a little bit, and pinch it closed. Now you can spin these so that the open part of the jump ring is on the inside of your votive, so that it looks very nice on the outsides. Before you light your votive, make sure that it's sitting on something fireproof, just for safety's sake, and it can add another decorative element as well. You can use a regular votive candle. Make sure that it's about an inch away from the side so that the heat won't affect your pieces. Or you can use a battery-operated votive, which is even safer.